Well, hello everybody, and welcome to another week of online rehearsals with Worsley Concert Band. I hope you're all keeping safe and well in this heat, and I'm sure a strange few of you are probably even enjoying it as well. But as you can see in this household, we've decamped to the sofa and just sort of spending all the time in the vicinity of windows and trying to cool down, because this is not a house that handles heat well. We've got a half husky and myself and Mark, who are very, very warm-blooded. So we're sweating buckets over here, but hopefully by the time this comes up, it'll have cooled down a little bit for the evening. And of course, then we're supposed to have snow on Monday, so who knows with British weather. But I figured let's have a nice little ease into Easter with just five pieces. But all fairly sort of technically demanding, with the exception of a couple that are just chucked in for fun. So we're going to start off this rehearsal with Reiniki and Rise of the Firebird. Let's get us in the Reiniki mood. So here we go with Rise of the Firebird, pressing play in 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cracking way, I think, there to start rehearsal, blow some cobwebs out and get us breathing, getting some nice cold air into our lungs, hopefully. So there we have it, Rise of the Firebird, to start this evening's rehearsal. Now, for anyone who has not had an email, which hopefully is none of you, or just doesn't read their emails, a little reminder about what's going on for Easter. So last week, we had a really lovely Zoom rehearsal to mark our anniversary of doing things online. And so that was fantastic, and we really enjoyed it, and I put the screen recording of me conducting up onto the YouTube the day after, so that, you know, you could still play along even if you couldn't make the Zoom. And because that worked so well, what we've decided is we're going to keep doing that, but every other week, so that, you know, people who can't join in at that time on a Wednesday still have a chance to join in, you know, on YouTube, or alternatively have small children in the house, or any of the above really, which means that you can't play on a Zoom call at 8 o'clock at night, and that's completely fine. So we've got it on, we'll put them up on YouTube as well, and we'll do that every other week. However, next week, next Wednesday, there will be no rehearsal, because on Sunday the 11th of April, we are having our online Wimband Day, which culminates at the end of it in a play-along session of all the music we've been covering through lockdown, and well, everything that's in the pads now will be covered in that session, and that will be on Zoom on Sunday. So that'll be Sunday the 11th. So we're not going to have a rehearsal next week and pretend we did the Easter holidays, which of course we haven't really. We didn't really even stop that well for Christmas, sort of cracked on quite quickly. But we are having a little break for Easter, sort of, not having a rehearsal next Wednesday, so that you can join in on the play-along session on Sunday. So there we have it. The sign-up for that is on our website. It's the one that I've not put on, which I will put on now, just, you know, for ease. So it's that bad guy, worsleyconcertband.co.uk. So that the sign up for that is on there. You do need to sign up, otherwise you won't get a link to join. Pretty logical, really. So yes, that will be next Sunday, a little play along session on Zoom, and right before that, the hard piece rehearsal, which will cover Rainy Key's Goddess of Fire. So if you like Rise of the Firebird, even just listening to it, then definitely sign up for the rehearsal on Goddess of Fire as well, because it's a fantastic piece of music. Lovely. Carrying on now. Hopefully I've waffled on enough to give you a little bit of a break. We're going to crack on with some Spark, very different. We're going to carry on with Klezmer Carnival. So here we go, a nice long one here to practice your stamina, practice pacing yourself. So don't go hell for leather straight off, give yourself some time, breathe, you know, really, really pace it up and just try and practice, you know, your dynamics and all the other bits and pieces whilst not going too for it too quickly, because otherwise you'll end up just burnt out, and we don't want that at all. So here we go, pressing play on Klezmer Carnival in 3, 2, 1.
1, 2, 3, 4. Percussion. Roll 2, 3 and 1. 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and pause. 3, 4, off. 1, 2, 3, and one. One. 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and pause. 3 and 4 and 70. Off. And 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4.
74.
Thank you. One, two, and three, four, and one. And
oh,
one, two, and three, four, and one.
Don't push too soon.
Two, three, and
one,
two, three, four, one. One, two, three, and one, two, three, four, one. Two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And a one,
six.
Two, three, four, one.
How do we cope with that? We make it all the way through without dying, or have we sort of collapsed into a puddle of sweat on the floor? I'm quite impressed that I'm not a puddle of sweat on the floor. Quite proud of myself, actually. I think I've done quite well there. Well done. I'm dressed appropriately, clearly. Just about cool enough. And I've not got a really noisy fan whirring as well, so I'm very, very pleased with this. I think I've got an optimal setup here. I've done very well for the heat, all things considered. Although I know it's sort of, it's this false spring, isn't it, that's a thing. Where it gets warm and you think, oh yeah, this'll, I can manage this, this is fine. And then it goes cold again, and then all of a sudden summer arrives and you think, good God, no, I couldn't handle the heat, I was very, very wrong. But hey, we've done well, we've coped with Klezmer Carnival and Rise of the Firebird, so I think we deserve something a little bit more relaxed now, don't we? Yes, I think so indeed. So we're going to go on to Skyfall now, a bit more relaxed, a little bit sort of more simplistic, however... The things that really matter are playing what's on the page, not what's in your head. So don't just go, I remember the tune from when it came out, I'll just play the tune. No, because nobody in this arrangement is a soloist. You all at least have somebody else, one other part, playing the tune with you if you have the tune. So you have to play exactly what is on the page. You can't just make it up, I'm afraid, which I know is a bit depressing, but you know. Also, when we get back, I think I'm probably going to put a little two-bar repeat in. Because it just stresses me out too much, but I'm not enough of an audio genius to be able to do that on the track. So that'll be for when we get back, I think, putting in a little repeat there just to make it a four-bar phrase at the beginning, not a two-bar phrase, because bars three and four should really be repeated for it to make sense that they're not, and I find it very stressful at times. But hey, it's a good arrangement, good bit of fun. One little thing, flutes, you are always quite high in your register, so you will be loud. You definitely don't need to overblow for this one. In fact, if anything, take it four bars at a time when we're back to real rehearsals, because you probably can. It'll be very, very loud and very overpowering otherwise, because we're always sitting up on these top Cs, and we want to avoid overbalancing everything else. It was something that was brought up at the end of rehearsal last week, about when can we get back to in-person rehearsals, and the answer is there is no answer really, which is quite frustrating, because we are sort of bound by the community centre. It's only a certain size, it'll only fit a certain number of us with social distancing, and also, you know, they're not open yet, so we can't even sort of make plans, go in and measure things up and whatnot, because they're just not open. So that's what we're sort of bound by at the moment. Technically we could start outdoor rehearsals, again with social distancing, from the 17th of May, but that is a question of finding a space, whether people actually want to do that, or whether they just want to wait until the 21st of June, hopefully, cross your fingers, to go back to things, you know, with mitigated circumstances, you know, removed. So completely up to the membership really what we want to do, if it is that, you know, you'd rather sort of stay safe until the 21st and avoid any, you know, avoid coming back and thinking, oh, it's not how I remember it, that's absolutely fine. Or if you want to sort of say, hey, come on, we can do it, let's try an outdoor rehearsal, then we can look at starting to make plans for the 17th of May onwards. But that's completely up to the membership, really. So, yes, hopefully you've all recovered from Klezmer Carnival now. And so we will crack on with Skyfall. Pressing play in 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, and... I think that's a proper sort of classic Bond tune. I really do love that, actually. It's a fantastic arrangement, and horns especially. I know you must have the most fun with that massive, massive tune. I've forgotten where it starts. At 43, just huge, huge noise, and it's perfectly suited for that upper tessitura of the horn. Just sounds fabulous. But if that's a little bit much to sort of whack up to that top G at double forte in the middle of a concert programme, I don't think anyone would blame you for sort of playing a lower G there in the third bar of 43. I don't think anyone would mind at all. However, it sounds awesome, so, you know, try and do it, because it sounds great. Lovely, there we go. I think that's a fantastic little concert filler, that, actually. It's a brilliant piece, brilliant arrangement of, you know, something that... I mean, I remember it being the massive zeitgeist culture moment. You know, every single teenage girl, you know, wanted to sing it with a big band. Oh, that was me. Oh dear. Oh god. Yes, there's some very embarrassing footage out there on YouTube if you search hard enough. But, you know, loads of people did great arrangements of it, and this is just one of them. You know, there's plenty of things that it was arranged really, really well for youth ensemble specifically. Because that's the thing, it doesn't matter whether you are an adult leisure time group or, you know, a youth music group in a, you know, music service. That doesn't necessarily matter. What matters is that they're cracking arrangements. And so that's the thing that really counts. If something sounds good, who cares what it was written for originally, whether it was written for the Fife Band of Cornwall or, you know, some symphony orchestra somewhere. It doesn't make a difference. If you like the music, then who cares what it says on the front of it? So, yes. And I suppose that leads in quite well to saying that our next in our Inspirations interview series is out this Friday with Paul Hornsby. So you see what I'm doing here? I'm sort of bookending that Easter break. I'm doing so well. with Paul Hornsby and talking about some amazing music and, you know, what we're doing with our, what he's doing with his life and where that's come from when I was, you know, yay big. Playing in the Great Gwent Youth Symphonic Winds. So I'll pop a link to some Great Gwent stuff in the description just so that you can sort of see where we've come from. That's sort of, you know, Paul out the front of a very large symphonic wind orchestra and little tiny me somewhere in there probably. Yes, just so that you sort of know a little bit before the interview drops on Friday. Lovely. That's a good little break, isn't it? And you hardly need it because, you know, we're not doing anything hard next. It's not like we're doing Into the Storm. No, not at all. So hopefully those of you that were at Zoom rehearsal last week, this is feeling a little bit more manageable now that we've sort of gone over a few of the major components, major rhythm components, and, you know, how it all links in. And hopefully, you know, you can start enjoying it a little bit. Like I said, in the Zoom rehearsal, we'll decide when we get back whether we want to do it in person or not, or whether it's just one that we kind of want to play along to a nice recording at home. Doesn't bother me. Happy to do either. So, you know, we will have a little look when we come back to rehearsals as to whether we want to do it in a concert one day, because obviously it is quite tricky to get together with everyone. But for now, you're playing along to a great recording, so just enjoy the experience of playing through something that's quite tricky and good fun like this, like the Smith Into the Storm. Here we go. Pressing play in 3, 2, 1.
1 and 2 and 3 it and means four. Forte. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Roll.
Ready?
2, 3, 4, 1. One, two, three, and four, and one. and two and three and four 72. And 74. 2, 3, 4, 1.
Together and 98.
Trill.
Hold it.
1, 2, 3, 4. Off. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Off.
You made it. Relax. Everything is great. What I think would be really fantastic, at the very least, is to sort of, at the very least, give it a go when we get back to real life rehearsals, because especially this middle section from 74 would be really incredible to practice playing as one. So playing essentially without me, chamber music, ideas is what we want here. And so if you're thinking about improving your internal pulse, why don't you sign up for, oh God alive, it was the worst transition ever, I'm very sorry. However, internal pulse is very, very important, and especially one of the most important things is rhythm. I will forgive wrong notes every day of the week, but wrong rhythms are really irritating. So rhythm is incredibly important. I've seen quite a few people already have signed up for the Understanding Rhythm session to start the online Wind Band Day on Saturday the 11th. And I can highly recommend it. I do think it's my husband Mark running it. He is a fantastic theoretical musician. Very, very good with the theory. Rubbish at other things, obviously. I've yet to find something as rubbish out. It's very irritating. But yes, and it's incredibly useful to know your theory behind rhythm, especially, all the things sort of like, cadences and chord changes and all the rest of it, you can probably get away without, but the basics of rhythm and applying those basics of rhythm to more complicated, horrible looking things, horrible looking time signatures, horrible looking denominations, lots of lines, lots of semiquavers, demi-semiquavers, hemi-semiquavers, hemi-demi-semiquavers. That's very, very important and very, very useful. So I can thoroughly recommend that one because, unfortunately, much as it pains me to admit, he's really rather good at what he does. And if you want to see what it is that he does, there's a sort of little bit of a teaser, in a way, on his YouTube channel. He's very active on YouTube. And there's some Music Theory Minutes with Mark, which was a great title. We were so proud of ourselves. Those are on his YouTube and also linked in the description, should you like to check them out. So yes, there we have it. Lots and lots of exciting things happening next Sunday, and hopefully you enjoy the interview coming out with Paul on Friday. And yes, a week off-ish, well, a Wednesday off next week for Easter, so nothing next Wednesday, and then obviously Sunday, a full day of Zoom fun, link in the description down below, lots and lots and lots going on. And yes, that will be that, and then we'll look to develop sort of a Zoom YouTube schedule, as it were, of what we're going to do with our Wednesday rehearsals after that. So yes, there you have it, lots of exciting music, and we're going to close off with just one more wonderfully exciting piece. We're going to finish off with just for some good old-fashioned fun, we're going to have a blow through Wicked. So here we go for Wicked, pressing play in 3, 2, 1.
1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause. 2, 3, 4.
Really pay attention to those accidentals. Remember to read what's on the page. Don't play what's in your head.
And 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Thank you. 4. One and two and three and four and one, two, three, four.
Every time I forget to take that off, I'm going to leave myself a note. Second I finish this. Wonderful, wonderful little selection of pieces there. And if you've enjoyed that, then that's wonderful. And hopefully you'll have a lovely, safe Easter weekend and enjoy time with children, grandchildren, or dread it and count the days until they go back. That is also fine by me. Just make sure that you're staying safe and healthy and sticking to all of our COVID guidelines. I appreciate they can be quite confusing, but you know, just think about it. If you're not sure, don't. Pretty easy, isn't it? So just make sure that we're all staying safe and healthy, because I'd love to see plenty of you next Sunday, not struck down with the lurgy. So I shall hopefully see you all next Sunday. Have a lovely Easter, and I will see you all then. So, bye for now.